Okay, so let's talk about the third problem. Like for this weekly contest 300, the third problem name is number of people aware of a secret. Okay, so this is the problem which troubled me the most. Like if you look at my submissions, yeah, you can see I've got first wrong answer, then finally accepted. Like when I got first wrong answer, I have moved out to the fourth problem. And I found the fourth problem quite much easy. Okay, like yeah, I have solved it within 5 minutes. But yes, this third problem is quite tricky. Okay, so let's begin how we are going to solve this problem efficiently. Like the also one more important thing, this constraints is going to play an important role in building up the solution. So on day one, one person discovers a secret. You are given an integer delay, which means that each person will share the secret with the new person every day starting from delay days after discovering the secret. Okay, suppose I am the person and I have discovered the secret on day one, then I will start spreading the secret from day equal to delay plus one, and I will forget the secret. And you are also given some integer forget, which means that each person will forget the secret, forget days after discovering it. So I have discovered the secret on day one. So I will start forgetting the secrets from day equal to one plus forget. Okay. If you are not getting it, no need to worry about it. I will explain all the things with the help of examples. A person cannot share the secret on the same day they forgot it or any day afterwards. Given an integer n, we need to return the number of people who know the secret at the end of day n. Since the answer may be very large, return it modulo 10 raised to the power 9 plus 7. Okay, so let's understand this problem in a simpler words. Suppose a person, let's say A, discovered the secret on day X. Okay, and suppose a person B, it discovers the secret on day Y. And there is a delay value, which is D, and forget value, which is F. So according to this problem statement, it says that when a person discovers this secret on day X, he will start spreading the secret, like A will start spreading the secret from day number X plus D, and it goes up to X plus F minus 1. Okay, so in other words, A will start spreading the secret from day number X plus D, spread to each one new person, and A will stop spreading the secret, forget, from day number X plus F. This is quite important. Okay, so this data is quite important. And similarly for B, B will start spreading the secret to each one new person from day number Y plus D, and B will stop spreading the secret from day number Y plus F. This is the problem. This is the main theme of the problem you need to understand. So at the end of the day N, we need to return the number of people who know the secret at the end of the day. So I will discuss this example. This is quite interesting. So also constraints is 1000, you can build up O of n squared time solution. Okay, and that will be good for this problem to understand also. So I will discuss O of n squared time and O of n space solution in this video. So let's understand this problem with the help of examples first. N6 delay to forget 4. Okay, so we have n equal to 6, 6 amount of days, and delay value as 2 and forget value as 4. Okay, so let me write down day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5, and day 6 finally. Okay, so we need to account for number of people that are present in the respective days. Okay, like how many persons are aware about the secrets. On day 1, only one person, let the name of the person be A, knows the secret. Now the person A knows the secret. Let me change the color, that would be good. So the person A knows the secret. So A starts spreading the secret from day 1 plus 2, which is 3. Note that day number plus delay value, and A will stop spreading the secret from day number 1 plus 4, 5. So we are going to denote it by 3, 5. Okay, now on the second day, you can see day number is 2 and still it is strictly less than 3. So A will keep the secret as it is. Now for day 3, you can see this 3 value is greater than or equal to this one. So A will spread the secret to one more person, B. So we will include the entry of B also. So it will be 3 plus 2, which is coming out to be 5. And B will forget the secret from day number 3 plus 4, which is coming out to be 7. Now at day 4, you can see 4 is greater than or equal to 3. So A will spread the secret to one more person. And 4 is strictly less than 5. So B will not spread the secret. So it will be like there will be 3 persons that are knowing the secret. A will spread the secret to person C. Like A will tell the person that yeah, this is the secret. So we will encounter, we will include the entry of C also. So 4 plus 2, like C will start spreading the secret from day 6. And C will forget spreading the secret from 4 plus 4, which is 8. Okay, now for day 5, you can see 5 is exactly equal to this value. It means that A will forget the secret. Okay, so we will not include A right now. Now let's talk about B. So you can see B, so day number is 5 and this is also 5. Like B will start telling the secret to each new person from day 5. So B will spread the secret, A will not spread the secret. And what about C? Its value is 5 and it is coming out to be 6. So C will spread the secret to each new person from day 6. So C will not spread the secret. So A will be eradicated from the list of person which knows the secret. B will be included, C will be included. And B will spread the secret, C will not spread the secret. So our new list of person which knows the secret would be B, C, and we are going to include the person D also, because B will spread the secret to one new person, C will not spread. So we have D over here. Okay, and let's include the entry of D, which is 5 plus 2, which is coming out to be 7, and 5 plus 4, which is coming out to be 9. Okay, what about day 6? You can see 6. 6 is, you can see this entry is eradicated. Only BCD is present. 6 is greater than or equal to 5. 6 is greater than or equal to 6. Okay, so it means that two more entries will come up. Okay, so I will write down B, C, D, and we will be having E and F. Okay. Yeah, so there will be total 5 persons that will know the secret. Note that B, C and D are already present, and you can see B will spread the secret because day number is 6 and current value is 5. Like B will start spreading from day 5, and similarly C will also spread because its value is 6 and it is also 6, and D will not spread because it starts spreading from day 6 and current day number is 6. So there will be 5 persons that will know the secret at the end of the day 6. So how we are going to implement all that efficiently, because at each time number of persons may increment very large. So what we will be doing over here is we will be maintaining 3 things. We will be maintaining a array of size 3 for each day, how much persons will be included and what will be their delay value, like what will be their day number from which they start telling secret to each new person, and what will be the day number at which they will stop spreading the secret to each new person. So we will maintain 3 things. Okay, so first thing would be like current day number plus delay value, and second thing will day number plus forget value, and third term will be count. Count will denote number of persons that are included during current iteration, like for the current day. Okay, now if you're at day 6, you can see there are exactly 2 entries that is being added to the current list of persons. So this array would be you can see day plus D, you can see E is added right now. So it would be current day number 6 plus delay value 2, and this will be also 6 plus 4, and number of persons added is 2. E and F both will have same day plus D value and day plus F value, which are the day numbers for like from which it will start spreading the secret, and the day number from which it will forget the secret respectively. Okay, so this is actually the array that we want. Okay, so let's understand how we are going to implement that efficiently. So we are going to define LL as long long and mod as 1e power 7. Okay, so why not I look out my submissions which I have accepted during the contest. Yeah, that is good. So let's start from day 2 and taken as 1. Taken as 1 is not going to be useful over this entire code. I don't know why I have done over here. Okay, so just forget about it. Okay, so I will start from day 2 and we have array of persons, and the very first person is delay plus 1. Like that will be exactly one person, and it will start spreading the secret from day number delay plus 1. And it will stop spreading the secret from day number forget plus 1. Okay, and we are going to iterate till day less than or equal to n. So first of all, we will remove all those persons who forgets the secret. Like for the current day, like in this example, you can see when we encounter day number exactly equal to 5, you can see we are going to eliminate, you can see day number 5. Eliminated, we have B, like we have eliminated B because B forget value, A's forget value, which is 5, like day 1 plus 4, which is 5, and it exactly matches with this value day number 5. So it means that A will not spread the secret starting from day 5. Yes, this is the correct statement. Because the value is 5 and day number is 5. So A will stop spreading the secret starting from day 5. Okay. So we are going to eliminate that person from the list. So while persons not equal to empty and persons second value is exactly equal to day, we will erase the entry from the persons list. And finding the number of persons that can spread the secret. So we will iterate in the persons list and we will check it out if x0, which is the delay value, like the corresponding day number from which the person will start spreading the secret, is strictly less than or equal to day, then the person will spread the secret. So I will find out the number of new persons that the current person will spread the secret, which will be count plus equal to x2. Okay, and count, we are going to take it modulus also because it may overflow. And finally, we will push back the person, number of persons that will have, that will be included in the list. It will be count and their day number from which they will start spreading the secret, which will be day plus delay. And from the day number from which it will stop spreading the secret, which will be day plus forget. And we need to increment day each time. And finally, after all the iteration stops, we need to find out number of persons which have which are aware about the secret. So we will iterate in the persons list and we will add up all those count that is present over there. And you need to take care about the modulus sign. Okay, so this is all about this problem. Note that the time complexity of this problem is O of n squared because day will go up to n, and each time we are going to add up all this one, so O of n squared, and space complexity is O of n. Okay, so yeah, if you guys have still any doubts, you can reach out to us through the comment section of the video, and thank you for watching this video.